Thanks for watching Community Update for Friday, September 25th. I'm Steve Erickson. A reversal this week from the Minnesota State High School League. On Monday, the league's board of directors voted to move football and volleyball from the spring back to the fall. CTN Steve Antis has reaction from Coon Rapids High School.
We have a really strong squad coming back.
Fourth-year head coach John Enns was happy to be back in the field house with his volleyball players after getting the go-ahead from the State High School League.
I was sitting by my computer listening to the meeting, refreshing Twitter about every 30 seconds just to see what was happening with the vote. And then as soon as that vote went down, I kind of went into scramble mode to get our season put together in about 7 days.
Team tryouts will start next Monday with lots of fresh talent vying for a spot on the team. The training time will be shorter than normal before they face their conference rivals in a match.
It's definitely going to be difficult to get back in shape, but like I said, we're ready to work hard and we're super excited to start playing again.
Equally excited is the Cardinal football team, who are giddy to get back on the gridiron after last year's Section 7 5A title win.
But we're really excited about this opportunity ahead of us.
Following the guidelines from the State High School League, head coach Nick Russin leads his team with a number of safety protocols, like keeping players in pods.
We and all our coaches are wearing masks. We social distance and clean as much as possible.
The safety guidelines football follows does not yet allow for boys to tackle, something they'd like to practice before their first game.
We're all putting in work, going 100% every day. You see we're running, have to get back in shape.
As for fans in the stands,
it looks like it'll be 125 home, 125 away.
As of right now, we've been told that we won't have any fans. We'll still need parent volunteers to help out run our matches, and so we hope to be able to get some of our parents in the building and help work our games.
Go Cardinals!
From Coon Rapids High School, I'm Steve Antis reporting for Community Update.
Football will play 6 regular season games. The State High School League also approved a 2-week football postseason, which begins the week of November 16th.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Sports Night. I'm Joe Young.
And I'm Howie Shapiro. And Joe, I'll tell you, it's been 6 months. So glad to be back. You're clean shaven,
which you look great for the first time in six months.
After a long break due to COVID, Sports Night returned to the air this week. Hosts Joe Young and Howie Shapiro run down all the high school sporting action each week during the school year. This week's show covers soccer, cross country, tennis, and swimming and diving. Middle and high school students in the Anokanapin School District will return to the classroom next week. Last week, elementary students started classes in the hybrid learning model, which has students learning in the classroom 2 days a week and online the other 3 days. Schools have spent months coming up with plans to make buildings as clean and safe as possible for students and staff, along with implementing social distancing measures. Middle and high school students have spent the first 2 weeks of school completely online, but will shift to the hybrid model next week. The deadline to fill out the 2020 census is quickly approaching. You have until September 30th to fill it out. So far, more than 98% of Minnesotans have been counted by self-reporting or through a census taker. Nearly 85% of Coon Rapids residents responded on their own, which is 10% higher than the state average. The census done every 10 years is critical in determining our representation in Congress and the amount of federal funding our state and local governments receive. Good news for property owners in Anoka County. This week, the Board of Commissioners voted to hold the property tax levy flat next year, resulting in no increase for 2021. Officials say the budget reflects the priorities of the county to modernize and shift its service delivery models and ensure the safety and health of its citizens. The final budget and tax levy will be approved in December. Another veteran in Coon Rapids has a new roof this week thanks to some special volunteers. Stephanie Vanderbile, who served in the Air Force for more than 9 years, received a new roof Wednesday as part of the Owens Corning National Roof Deployment Project. Through a partnership with Purple Heart Homes, Vanderbile was selected as the recipient of the roof replacement. She and her husband Joel, who's also an Air Force vet, moved into the home about a year ago.
When we bought our house right before it closed, that storm came through last September, and it blew down trees and took down the fence right before our closing, and that's really was the focus on getting that back up from the previous owners. So they were working on that with insurance, and then this summer came around And we started watching all of our neighbors getting their roofs replaced, and we were like, oh, maybe there is some damage. And we looked at it, and we're like, yeah, we did get some damage that got overlooked.
So it's the third year in a row that we've done them. And we found that, the candidates that have come to us that have needed help kind of getting some of those projects done that they can't get on their own.
Advantage Construction donated the labor, while the Owens Corning Foundation donated the roofing materials. Back in July, an Army veteran in Coon Rapids also received a new roof through the program. You could call it a beauty pageant with a purpose. A Coon Rapids mom and business owner recently launched a philanthropy-based pageant company. CTN's Jennifer Anderson stopped by their first Give Back event at the Coon Rapids Dam.
On this Saturday in the park, you won't find a stage or lights or ball gowns. Just pageant princesses doing a little bit of good.
A lot of birthday party stuff like candles, toys, and all of that.
These girls and their families are packing birthday kits to donate to food shelves in school districts throughout the metro.
I think it will make them really happy because, like, they don't have, like, the money to afford it.
Gloss Pageantry hosted the event. Gloss is the brainchild of Coon Rapids native Amy Ann Dixon.
It actually started with my daughter Bianca. She's been competing in pageants since she was 9 months old. And so it kind of turned into a family fun thing. We love getting involved in the community. So we thought, why not start an organization focused on that?
Gloss hosted its very first pageant in August. There, they collected thousands of donated birthday items. With each pageant will be a similar Gloss Give Back event, like the birthday kits. For Gloss girls, after the win comes the work.
We're calling it your sash story. So it does encourage them to actually go out and use their title rather than kind of add it to their collection of different crowns. It gives them that drive and that motivation to enhance their sash story, which I think is something super unique to pageantry.
Gloss organizers want to grow young leaders of the future and hope the feeling the girls get from giving back,
love and happiness,
is the real pageant win. For Community Update, I'm Jennifer Anderson.
Gloss founder Amy Ann Dixon knows a little something about pageants herself. In 2005, she was the Coon Rapids Teen Queen. You can help put a smile on the face of a local child by donating a gently used or new bike next weekend. Dozens of Alina Health locations, including Mercy Hospital, will be collecting bikes on Saturday, October 3rd from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. This is the 10th year in a row Alina has teamed up with Free Bikes for Kids, a nonprofit organization that repairs and distributes bikes to kids in need. Last year, the event collected 5,000 bikes. All right, that brings us to the end of today's show. Thanks for watching. We'll see you back here again next week.